In its nearly 60 years of service, Alvin is reaching new heights by going to new depths it's never reached before. Last Thursday, Alvin and its crew of three dove nearly 4 miles down into the Puerto Rico Trench north of San Juan.
As far as milestones are concerned, this is certainly up there.
Andy Bowen is director of the National Deep Submergence Facility at Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute. He says the dive was a critical part of the recertification of Alvin following a recent 18-month $50 million overhaul and upgrade to the sub's capabilities.
That dive is essentially the sort of crowning achievement, if you will, of this most recent upgrade, the main portion of which involved the addition of a new hull for Alvin.
Beyond increasing Alvin's range, it now puts nearly all of the ocean's floors within reach of the longest operating and most successful human-occupied submersible program in the world.
The milestone dive last week really is critical, I think, in enabling ocean scientists to reach a new part of the ocean that has, to a large degree, been unexplored. The idea that the submersible can now reach 99% of the seafloor and the ocean above it is almost certainly going to result in astounding and unexpected discoveries.
Alvin and I were actually launched in the same year, 1964. And in those 58 years, that little white submarine has conducted almost 5,100 successful dives. Perhaps none more iconic than a dive in 1986 when Robert Ballard and Alvin first explored the wreck of the Titanic. I'm Doug Meehan, WCVB, News Center 5.